What's up everybody, in this video we are going to download OPay on our phone, set it up and do everything we need to do to have the account running. So let's get right to it. Is OPay even safe to use? So who's backing them up? Well, OPay is licensed by the CBN, insured by the NDIC and trusted by over 18 million users. Easy and instant account opening with your phone number, name, BVN or other national means of verification, and enjoy an amazing welcome bonus, amazing all payment from one app, and enjoy free transfer and transaction bonus, free debit card with bonuses up to 15% annual interest on flexible savings with daily interest and unlimited withdrawal. 24 hours, 7 days a week customer support is always available for you. Seriously? Oh boy, let's get right into it. Let's download this app right now. Go ahead and click on the Play Store. Once it opens up, okay, it's loading. Let's wait a little for it to finish loading. Well, we're coming up here to the search bar. Click on it. That search box. Click on it and type OPay. If you notice, OPay was already showing on the front page, but if it doesn't show, it's not being suggested to you, let's go ahead and type it in the search. Now come up here and click on OPay on the top part so that it can open up, okay, like this. After now, we're going to click on install and note that OPay is number one, top three in finance. Seriously. Okay. We're installing it now. It's gonna take a couple of minutes. It's pretty light to install. Okay, so once it's done installing, okay.
So we click on the app, now it has installed. Once it opens up, you see easy and instant account opening. Open an account easily and instant with phone number or name. That's good. Manage all payment from one app. Seriously, free debit card. That's nice. I mean, seriously. Available with BVN zero fee application, ATM withdrawals, maintenance, and accept at any POS, ATM, and online channels. Which means they can make online payments. Up to 50% annual interest. That is really nice. Licensed by the CBN and insured by NDIC. Cool. So let's go ahead and click on create a new account.
Then you can see the country flag. If the system has it wrong, you can choose the right country. Then the second place, you're going to put in your phone number. After typing in your phone number into this box, you're going to click on get OTP. You're going to receive that OTP. It's a 6-digit number. Then you're going to now type in that number into this box down here. After typing in, you click on confirm. Note that if you have used the phone number before, it's going to tell you that this phone number is linked to an existing account. So you have to use the phone number that you have not linked to an account already, or you could just go back to that former account that you opened and just use that instead of creating another OPay account. So let's click on back to remove this. So after typing in your phone number, click on get OTP. About maybe 5 to 10 minutes to receive the OTP. So this is the OTP from OPay, and that is the code I need to copy into this box right here that says enter the 6-digit. So let's go ahead and type it in there. Okay, after typing it in, come here and click on confirm. Okay, so here we are on the next page. In this page, we're going to put in our password, and the password is going to contain numbers. So let's go ahead and type in our number, our password in the first row. Then we're going to repeat that same password in this second row too. Let's do that. So go ahead and type it in now. So after typing in the password, if you want to view it, you just need to click on that eye icon. You can click on it to hide it again. So let's move on from here. Now come down and click on done if you're okay with that password.
Now, make sure that the password you're using is a strong one. If your password is weak, it's going to tell you that your password is weak, that you need to retype it again, which means you need to change it. And also make sure you're not using a password you have used for another account or a social media. Make sure you're using something fresh and new. Okay? So right now, you need to allow OPAY to take picture and record a video. Click on Allow. So, okay, after clicking on Allow, it says allow OPAY to access photo, media, and files on your devices. You're going to grant it that access too. So right here, you're going to take a picture. This is for security, so that in future, if something goes wrong, you can always come back and say, yo, I have a picture account, a picture attached to my account. So this is me. Look at me right here. So right now I need to take a picture of myself. So I need to make sure I face the light, so that we have a bright face and everything is showing well. So I need to dress back and make sure my head somehow fits this little box here in a way. So I need to dress back a bit more. Once my head fits perfectly, or it's in the right position to automatically take the picture. Okay, so that is it. So if it doesn't, you can also just press it too. So right now we're going to click on confirm to confirm it, or we can also click on try. So if you want to take another one, if you don't like the first one. Okay, well, I'm okay with this. So let's click on confirm. See here it says in progress, face recognition, please wait patiently. Okay, that's done with. Okay, so right now we are over to personal information. So now let's read what we're meant to do. It says please provide identification to ensure the security of your account. So the first box on top right, identification method. So that's the method you want to use to identify yourself, either your voter's card, NIN, or your BVN. So let's check what is there. So the option that we have right here is BVN, NIN, phone number, bank account, voter's card, and driving license. So I think I'm going with BVN. So underneath, I'll need to type in my BVN number. After typing it, I'm going to click on next. Now, if you don't want to put any form of identification into the application yet, you can go ahead and skip it. But I'm not sure how that might affect your account, though I think later on you still need to put it later on. But let's just do it now and just click on next. Okay, now the next page is open up and it says address. Enter detailed address for better security. So we have state, then we have LGA, that's local government. So I'll click on state and let's enter the state where we are currently, Lagos state. So we're going to click on confirm to confirm it. Okay, the next thing is LGA, that's local government area. So click on it. So let's look for a local government area. So you need to have an idea of your local government area. So let's keep on moving. Nope, this is not correct. So keep moving. Okay, yeah, this is right here. Confirmed. Then we need to click area. Okay, we don't have anything there. So let's leave that alone. Then come over to address. So we're gonna type in our address. After typing in our address, we're gonna click on done. On done, there's the next page and it says OPAY account is created successfully. Secure your account with email. We will send you an email if your account has any change, like password or device or a PIN. So go ahead and click yes to add your email to it. So here we are on the next page where we're going to type in our email address. So go ahead and type in your email address. After typing it, go ahead and click on next. Okay, after clicking on next, you're going to receive an email. In that email, there's going to be a code. Copy that code and paste it into these boxes.
then click on verify. So I'm having issues receiving the email, so I'm just gonna pass this side, go back. Yes, I'm out. So, but for now, I've created the OPay account. I can start using it, but maybe later on I will add the email. I'll link my email account to the OPay account. But for now, it's all done. Later. Okay, let's try again. Let's try linking the email to our PayPal account. Let's see. I'm sure it's gonna work. Come out to the left corner and click on the profile picture. So you can see right now it's opened up. So right here we can verify our email account. So click on here, type in our email. Next. Okay, there's a space, so let's move forward a bit. Okay. So right now we wait for the email. So let's go over the email app, click here. Oh wow, that's it. So this is the verification.
This is the verification code we are going to type into the box.
It's right here. So we go ahead and verify our email account. So let's go ahead and type this code, then click verify. And boom, we have verified it now. So at first it did not work, so I left it, but now it's working. Okay, so right now we have linked our email account to our OPay account. You can see it says verified. So it took me a couple of days. I mean, I just left it alone since I wasn't receiving any email from them. And I just came back to it and tried it out and it worked. So in case if you're having any issue with connecting your email account to your OPay account, just give them some time, maybe a couple of days or weeks, then come back and try it again. So now, how much can you put into your OPay account? So let's come down here that says tier 1. So right here it says daily transaction limit is 50,000. Maximum account balance is 300,000. So that's the maximum amount you can have in your OPay account. You can withdraw 50,000, and the maximum you can have in it is 300,000. Now move over here, it says daily transaction limit. We have here number tier 2 is 200,000. That's daily. That is the amount of money we can send out of our OPay account a day is 200,000 at tier 2. Maximum account balance is 500,000. So let's come over here to tier 3. Tier 3 is daily transaction limit. Maximum account balance is unlimited. As the maximum account balance is unlimited, and the daily transaction limit is 5 million. See, seriously, that is the maximum limit or amount of money you can transact out of your OPay. You can spend is 5 million
for a day.
So now, how are you going to be able to increase your tier from the tier 1 to tier 2 and the tier 3? So you might ask yourself, how do I upgrade in tier? Very simple. Just as right now you can see it says upgrade to tier 3. It's the same thing you're going to see when you need to upgrade to from tier 1 to tier 2. Mostly you might just need to submit a document or just perform a little task to upgrade to the next level. So for me to upgrade to tier 3, what I need to do is to submit a document. It could be a name or a voter's card. They can any form of government approved identification that you can submit to them. Just take a picture and send it to them. It's as simple as that. Now to upgrade to tier 3, because currently I'm on tier 2. To upgrade to tier 3, I need to submit my government issued ID and upload a photo of the ID. So let's see the type of ID we can submit. We can submit NIN, international passport, driver license, and voter's card. So if you have any of these, you can use it to increase the amount you can daily withdraw and amount you can save. So let's close this. So this is where you're going to click to upload the picture. So let's click here to view a sample. It says view sample. So this is right here. You have your national identity card right here. Then we have international passport. So these are some of the examples. So let's close this. Okay, so this is it, guys. This is how you can avoid unnecessary issue trying to open your OPAY account. So these are all the things you need to do and some of the documents you need to have. You need to have your NIN, voter's card, or a BVN account. Seriously. So thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. And check out my other videos right here.